everybody. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe. Here's an update on your forecast. First, an update on flood warnings. We still have two rivers that we're watching, and also a third, the Connecticut River up in Cohos County, especially in the Lancaster, Colebrook areas. So a heads up if you live near these rivers. Most of the flooding action has been minor, and the rivers are actually going down, of course, now that the heaviest rain has moved away. But still, something to keep a watch on if you happen to live near the Suncook or the Saco, which have been running very high due to the increased rainfall that we've had recently. Still some scattered showers going on, particularly across the eastern half of the state. And yes, that white you see, likely a few wet snowflakes that have been mixing in, mainly in the higher terrain. And that'll be the case as we go through the overnight too. Some much cooler air coming down behind the system that we had moved through last night and this morning. In fact, just a few thousand feet up above our heads, the temperatures are well below freezing. So right where the rain is falling, it's actually snow in many locations. So particularly the higher elevations, and in northern New Hampshire, there could be a little bit of light snow as we go through the overnight tonight. Then watching this next storm system. I know it's been just this parade of weather systems with rain showers, and that does not look like it's stopping anytime soon. We're in this kind of wet pattern and it continues on. This system here in the Ohio River Valley is going to just kind of move to the south of us tomorrow, but it will bring in the threat for a few more rain showers, particularly in southern New Hampshire. Now, I know there's some snow with that, especially in Chicago where it's 33 degrees. We will not see the snow from that, just some rain. But you see the really big divide here between the warm air to the south. Look at St. Louis, it's 78, and then Chicago only 33. So in between, a very stark contrast in a frontal boundary. And we happen to still be on the northern side of that frontal boundary, so our temperatures remain on the cool side. Here's tonight. Still some scattered snow showers in the higher terrain in the north country, but for the most part, it's partly cloudy. We'll begin the day tomorrow with some sunshine, and then as we get into the afternoon, the clouds return and likely some rain showers. I think the best bet is for Concord and points of the south to see some wet weather. And if you're heading into southern New England, like down into Massachusetts, that's where there'd be actually heavier rainfall. System, generally speaking, is actually diving to our south. It's even possible some of us don't see any rain, especially in central and northern New Hampshire. Monday, finally, almost a complete day where it's going to be dry and we'll see some sunshine. In the afternoon, clouds will increase and then eventually rain showers arrive in the overnight hours and continue into Tuesday. So this showery pattern just goes on. Tonight, temperatures in the 30s for the most part. Still a real cool feel even tomorrow, the 40s and 50s. Keep in mind, our average high for this time in April is about 63. So we're easily running 10 degrees or more below that. And tomorrow, again, it's mainly showers in the afternoon and in southern New Hampshire. Looks like a lot of rain on the 7-day forecast, and really it is. We have scattered showers likely nearly every day. Monday is bright and cool, temperatures in the 50s, then rain moves in late Monday night and through Tuesday. On and off showers Wednesday. Thursday is still rainy and cool, more showers Friday, and Saturday, hopefully, will start to dry things out with temperatures in the upper 50s.